Just for those folks that don't know, ALF stood for Atascadero Loaves and Fishes, and it's ALF now. I think you guys officially, because the resolution reads, resolution proclaiming September 10th, 2024, as ALF Food Pantry Day in the county of San Luis Obispo. Whereas ALF Food Pantry, located in Atascadero, was founded in 1984 and has provided hunger relief for 40 years. And whereas ALF Food Pantry served food insecure people in Atascadero, Templeton, Santa Margarita, Creston, and California Valley. And whereas in 2023, ALF Food Pantry distributed over 578,000 pounds of wholesome, nutritious food. And whereas ALF Food Pantry outstanding service was recognized when the Atascadero Chamber of Commerce named it the Community Organization of 2024, a testament to its impact and the community's support. And whereas ALF Food Pantry is open 5 days a week and provides food to over 40 households daily, including individuals, families, veterans, and seniors. One-third of those served are children. And whereas ALF Food Pantry is the largest all-volunteer organization in San Luis Obispo County, there are 100-plus volunteered and no paid employees. Whereas ALF Food Pantry derives funding primarily from individual gifts, as well as private and public grants and donations. Now, therefore, be it resolved and ordered that the Board of Supervisors of the County of San Luis Obispo, State of California, does hereby proclaim September 10th as ALF Food Pantry Day in San Luis Obispo County. Congratulations.
I want to thank the board for this tremendous honor. And I stand before you as an individual, but we are not just volunteers. We have an amazingly diverse group of people that manage to guide this organization that runs as a small business efficiently and effectively every day. Happen to have three members with me today, and all three of them, they're based mostly in the morning. They're coming in and they're setting up the pantry for the day. They're stocking shelves, they're building grocery boxes, they're organizing things for our afternoon distribution. Then our afternoon distribution team comes in, and then the next morning it all starts over again because our space is so limited. We're continuing our 5-year search for a new facility, and no, a lease option is not something that's feasible for us, but we have built up tremendous investment reserves, and we have completely paid for our building that we are in and operating in now, along with the solar on top. So I'm looking forward to a resolution of that perhaps very soon. There's some things have kind of come and gone, and I'm hoping we can succeed, because without that success, for us to sustain the exponential growth, particularly spiked during the pandemic, it kind of moderated a bit the second year of the pandemic, and now it's picked up again. We have had one day this year where we served 71 clients in one day. And those 71 clients represent between 1 and 8. So multiply that times at least 3 or 4. That's the number of individuals that we served food that is lasting, and their groceries exceeding over 100 pounds of groceries that they're carrying out to their cars will likely last them for the week at least. We're doing very well with maintaining that menu, but we do that only by now expending about $12,000 every month to purchase food. Not all of our food is through Fresh Rescue, and not all of our food is donated through in-kind. And we're making do with that, but go back 3-4 years where we could kind of roll over a little extra surplus into our investments, and now we're about balanced. We're getting by, but we need, we need more space. We certainly can always use volunteers, we are also examining different funding sources. We have an exceptional grant writer, but our grants generate about 1/3 of what our operating expense is. I'm very, very proud of this organization. I have expended more than a decade working with the organization initially as the grant writer and now as the board president. But again, it's not about me, it's about we and what this organization accomplishes. And it's discipline to do it the right way every day. And it's all for the clients in multiple communities in the North County. So thank you. Thank you again for the honor, and I share it with many.
Thank you so much. All right. I didn't know if there was anyone else that wished to speak on this item. Anyone else? Okay. Then we're going to bring this back to the board for any comments they may have. Supervisor Pichon.
I just want to thank you for all you do. I have donated food to the pantry before, and it's just wonderful people. It's a great organization, volunteer organization. And thank you on behalf of North County. Thank you for all you do.
And I want to give you my thanks as well. Whenever I've been down there, everyone's so hardworking and so kind and compassionate. It's just, you really have put together an amazing organization that just does so much for the folks in, well, in North County and all over the county, but I'm going to say mostly the folks in North County. So thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Supervisor Ortiz Lake.
Yeah, you're really on the front lines of seeing what's going on in the community and helping, you know, children, seniors, families in general, and seeing the kinds of struggles that they have. And I'm just so grateful for your work, as we've all noted. And also just working with, I was seeing your some of your information is that some of your spiritual centers, et cetera, are gathering food and then bringing it in. And so people can participate in many different ways. And I think that we all need to do our share in this great challenge we have in affordability and nutrition. And so thank you very much.
Mr. Gibson. Thank you, Madam Chair. I'll echo my colleagues' thanks and tell you that, you know, it was a really inspiring morning I spent touring your facility a couple years back, and the commitment of your staff, everybody involved in your organization, to serving this fundamental human need is truly cause for great joy and optimism. Mm-hmm. Many more years of pursuit of serving this mission. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank all of you for your wonderful comments. I do want to make a closing remark that would seem to be kind of an epiphany of our city business leaders. We hosted the Chamber Mixer in May, and the remark, and I know some that are with me to back me up here today agree, many of the business leaders came in and their remark was, I had no idea. Mm-hmm. They really, really had no idea how we do what we do and what we do. So along with that event coming up, the ALF Food Van, our flagship, and members of our organization will be in the Colony Days Parade. Looking forward to that. So thank you again. Okay.